Wherever you've been or what you've gone through, the Father is waiting for you. Let you begin a new family. You're welcome at Abba's house.
Welcome to Ron Phillips from Abba's House. I'm Angie McGregor.
And I'm Pastor Ron Phillips. Today, a life-changing truth.
Don't let Satan distract you from today's message, because if you will stay with us all the way through, you are going to gain a winning mindset.
You know, the Bible speaks of putting on the whole armor of God. And many of you already have a copy of our book, Everyone's Guide to Demons and Spiritual Warfare. But in that book, we talk about the whole armor of God. And one piece of that armor is the helmet of salvation. But we never talk about our thinking, our mind. And the Bible says, let this mind be in you which was in Christ Jesus. Satan gains access through our senses, primarily through our thinking. He can't read your mind, but he can plant a thought and build a stronghold and destroy your life. Your mind needs to be renewed. This week and next week, we're going to help you to walk in a renewed thinking. What I'm about to share with you is critical for the year that is before us. This has not been the best year of my life. I don't know about you. But a few months ago, when I was doing radio and talking about doing spiritual warfare, in the middle of the teaching on the whole armor of God, revelation began to flow into my spirit, and something happened in those radio studios. And I knew then I was to bring this message to you. And I was on the schedule for earlier in the year, but God postponed it to now. And I knew after Dutch Sheets was here that it was right on time. Because I believe that what you need and what we all need at this season in our church, in our family, and in America, and in our city, is to gain a winning mindset. Proverbs 23:7 says, as he thinks in his heart, so is he. And when you see the word heart in Old Testament and New Testament, it is not talking about that organ that's pumping blood, and it's not talking about your emotions. It's talking about your soul, that part of you that thinks and processes information. Whatever you see it, that's what it means. And when you turn over to the New Testament, Ephesians 6:17, he says, take the helmet of salvation. And a lot of times when we think of being saved, we think of emotion or feeling. But in the armor of God, salvation is described as that which protects your thinking. When you got saved, you didn't put your brain on a shelf. God made you with the capacity to think. In fact, when God breathed into Adam the breath of life, it was more than just oxygen. He created him in the image of God, gave him a mind to think, tested that by running the animals in front of him and him naming them, gave him a heart to love, and tested that by taking a rib from his side and creating a beautiful creature called a woman, thank God. And gave him a will to choose, a mind to think, a heart to love, a will to choose, and tested it with a tree in the garden. And that which makes you like God is your ability to think, love, and choose. You're not a dog. You're not an ape. You're not a cat. You're not the accident of evolution. You are created in the image of God. And you're going to understand before I finish this teaching that you have the inestimable privilege of being able to think God's thoughts after Him. And when you learn to do that, it will transform your life. Now, when Adam sinned, here's what happened. The Lord said, in the day you eat of that fruit, you will die. But let me ask you a question. Did he die physically? He lived nearly 1,000 years after that. Was God wrong? God's never wrong. What happened to Adam? Being made a Trinity, he had a body to operate in. He had a mind or a soul, a nephesh or a psuche is the Greek word, a psyche. And he had a spirit. He was a Trinity. Created the image of God. When Adam sinned, he died immediately in his spirit. Let me tell you what happened. The breath of God was more than oxygen that went in his lungs. The breath of God was the Spirit of God that made his spirit come alive. And when Adam sinned, God withdrew that breath. He could still breathe oxygen, but at that moment, the sentence of death came into his spirit. He died immediately in his spirit. Then man began to die progressively in his soul, in his thinking. His mind became corrupt, couldn't think right. And ultimately, even though he lived in nearly 1,000 years, Adam died in his body. And unless the rapture comes, you're going to die in that body you're in. Now, what happens when you get saved? Well, the process reverses. When you get saved, thank God, immediately your spirit comes alive, a breath called the Holy Ghost. You must be born of the Spirit, Jesus told Nicodemus. And the same breath that entered Adam's lungs comes into your spirit, and you come alive forever in your spirit. Immediately. People say, one day I'm going to have everlasting life. No, you got it the moment you got saved. In Him was life. Hallelujah. Now here's what's supposed to happen. In the process of time, not only are you saved in your spirit, but you ought to start getting saved in your thinking. Because you come alive immediately in your spirit, but progressively in your thoughts. And the reason some of you are saved and in a mess is your spirit came alive, but you still in stinking thinking. Something hadn't changed in your mind. And it's partly our fault in the church because we talk about saving your soul, and to us souls something we don't understand that nephesh in Hebrew and psyche is your thinking. Heart to love, mind to think, will to choose. That's what it is. That's your soul. That's your psyche. And so we've turned to humanistic thinking. And experts to take the place of the thoughts of God. But by the way, you get saved immediately in your spirit, progressively in your thoughts, but ultimately in your body at the resurrection. Give somebody a high five and say, glory to God. Now, understanding that, I want to mention in this brief message seven things to you, seven truths that lead to a victorious mindset. Let me remind you that Adam and Eve walked with God in the cool of the day. That sounds good, doesn't it? But that's not what the Hebrew says. The Hebrew says God walked with them in the Spirit. The word cool there is ruach, Holy Ghost, Spirit. So what before they fell, God would come and teach them. And they would think the thoughts of God. And when they fell, that opportunity left. They were driven out of the garden of education from God, out to a cursed world. And then they began to say, thank you, Lord, we'll take it from here. Wasn't long till Cain was murdering Abel. Wasn't long till every imagination and thought of man was on evil continually. Wasn't wrong till stinking thinking had taken over. Now, are you ready for these seven things? One, you are what you think. You are what you think. It doesn't matter what people think about you, what you say. When you're by yourself and what you think about yourself is who you are. And that's why some of you are saved, but you walked in here this morning and think you're the most rotten person in the world. Because maybe you sucked a cigarette or drank a beer or did something wrong. I got quiet in here when I said that. I'm going to teach you something about grace today before I get through. You're not saved because of what you do. He's saved because of what he did. And God isn't looking for a reformation of your life. He's looking for a transformation of your thinking. Then you'll know not to chew cigarettes and beer. But it'll be by the Spirit, not by the law. The letter kills. And the reason why some of you are miserable is you're still operating in your own thought process. Listen to what the Bible says in Genesis 6:5. After the fall of man, the Lord saw their wickedness of man and that every intent of the thoughts of his heart was on evil continually. Does it ever bother you that no matter how sanctified you think you are, you can get 5 minutes away from the meeting and think about something bad? Psalm 10:4, the wicked in his proud countenance does not seek God. God is in none of his thoughts. Psalm 94:11, the Lord knows the thoughts of man, that they are futile. I'm going to get this figured out. No, you're not. Bertrand Russell was an atheist all his life. They looked at him one day, he was about 60 years old, and they said, what are you going to do when you die? He said, when I die, I shall rot. Isn't that stupid? But when he came to die, he was screaming in terror. Because every thought of the most intellectual man in the world without God is futile. Matthew 15:19 says, out of your mind, out of your soul proceed evil thoughts. Evil thoughts. And as a man thinks in his heart, so is he. You are what you think. Now, number two, wrong thinking is dangerous rebellion and puts one in league with the enemy. When you were a bouncing baby boy, you were born in corruption. Now, you weren't lost, but you were going to be lost. You were protected by your innocence for a season. But you were born in sin. The sweetest baby that's ever lived could turn out to be Adolf Hitler if the thinking's not straightened out. Come on, somebody. Ephesians 2:3 said that you fulfilled the desires of the flesh and of the mind and were by nature children of wrath. You were born in your nature to go to hell and to think wrong. Quickly, Colossians 1:21, you who once were alienated and enemies in your mind, in your thinking. That's why some of you need to get out from in front of the television and the iPad and the iPod and the video game and begin to read the Word of God. I'm getting ahead of myself. Romans 8:7 says that your mind is at enmity against God. Every morning when you get up, you've got a war going on in your mind. And here it is. Either your spirit will govern what you think or your flesh will govern what you think. You're not two souls. I've heard people say, well, I my this old nature and I've got this. No. When you were born again, you got a new nature, and the old man died. You read the Bible. The old man's dead. But you got a reckoning in dead because you're still living in this body, the remnant of Adam.
You are what you think. Learn how to win the war over your mind with Pastor Ron Phillips' best-selling book, Everyone's Guide to Demons and Spiritual Warfare. This comprehensive manual gives you simple, powerful tools for outmaneuvering Satan in your daily life and thoughts. When you order, also ask for a copy of today's message to help you have a winning way of thinking. Call now, 1-800-877-6493, or order online at ronphillips.org.
Every morning when you get up, you've got a war going on in your mind, and here it is. Either your spirit will govern what you think, or your flesh will govern what you think. You're not two souls. I've heard people say, well, I this old nature and I've got this. No. When you were born again, you got a new nature, and the old man died. You read the Bible. The old man's dead. But you got to reckon it dead because you're still living in this body, the remnant of Adam. And limping around on my knee right now, I've cursed Adam a little bit, I got to tell you. Because the Lord said the reason you're limping on that knee is because he ate the thing he wasn't supposed to eat. Come on, somebody. Philippians chapter 3. For many walk of whom, verse 18, for many walk of whom I've told you often and tell you even weeping, they're enemies of the cross of Christ, whose end is destruction, whose God is their flesh, whose glory is in their shame. Now, how do they operate? They set their mind on earthly things. It's their thinking. Are you getting this? Verse 20, our citizenship is in heaven. I've got another book. I've got another constitution. I've got another way of thinking. Number three, all of you who are saved are considered in the Bible priests of God, which simply means you have access to God. So as believers, you have access to the thoughts of God. 1 Samuel 2:35, I'll raise up a faithful priest who shall do according to what is in my heart. And here's what God says, in my mind. God said, I want to do a download. We understand this with computers. You know, the computer people have a saying, GIGO, garbage in, garbage out. But do you know you can get a heavenly download of the right kind of thinking? God said, I want to reveal to those who have access to me what is in my heart and what my thinking is. Psalm 40, David cried out, many, O Lord my God, are your wonderful works which you have done, and your thoughts toward us can't be. God's thinking about you today. Boy, I think about the prodigal son. While he was having a good time in that land of sin, he wasn't thinking about God, but his father. But there was never a day his father wasn't thinking about him. I want you to know you may have walked in here today with everything in the world, your mind buzzing, but your Heavenly Father, your Lord Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit's been thinking about you. I feel like breaking into Willie Nelson. You're always on my mind. That's what God can say. You're always on his mind. Ah, there's never a moment he's not thinking about you, wanting to transfer to you the thoughts that can transform your life. Psalm 139, 17, how precious are your thoughts to me, O God. Hebrews 8:10, God said, I will put my laws, that's his word, in their mind and write them on their heart. Don't you ever think there's any premium on stupidity. And if anything's embarrassed me, it's a church that doesn't think. Anything's bothered me about the charismatic movement is some of the stupid stuff I've seen that isn't of God, isn't out of God, that people have quoted, misquoted Scripture and done. The only thing worse is Baptists denying against the Spirit. There's no premium on you not study to show yourself approved unto God. There's no premium on being ignorant. You say, well, I wasn't well educated. Well, if you can read, get a Bible. And the reason Ron Phillips writes books is because I can make it simple. I have the gift of taking those truths and distilling them down where you can understand them. 1 Corinthians 2:16, who has known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? You can't teach God anything. That bothers me about prayer. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, we come to you today, Lord. Do you know so-and-so and such is going on? Who do you think he is? You don't need to inform him of anything. I got news for you. He's ahead of you. Glory to God. And here's the wonderful thing. You can think the thoughts of God and you can have the mind of Christ. Philippians 2:5. Let this mind be in you. That was also in Christ Jesus. You say, well, he was Son of God. Yes, he was, but Philippians 2 said he emptied himself, not of his deity, but of the rights of his deity. And he operated as Spirit-filled man. He left us an example that we should follow in his steps. And here's what he said. You can do the works that I've done and greater works. But you can't do them if you don't think the thoughts of God. Let this mind... You need a change of your thinking today. Because some of you walked in here defeated. Some of you walked in here wondering what you're going to do. Some of you ain't got a clue. And I'm going to tell you, that's not bad. Because some people that think they've got a clue haven't got a clue. If you don't have a clue, it's good. You need to kind of clean the hard drive of the iPad or the computer and let there be a divine transfer of what God says. Colossians 2 says, set your mind on things above and not on things of the earth. Now, I've been going through an audit. Everybody say Christmas fun. But you know what changed it? When I thought about Matthew being a tax collector and how he got saved. And then I started praying. And honestly, I had a pleasant experience. Now you don't see nobody believes. I can tell you the Lord knows what he's about. And we've got to think like he would think. Come on, somebody. Let this mind, set your mind on things. But this is a choice you make in your life. Isaiah 55 said, let the wicked forsake his way and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Do you understand what repentance is? It's not crying. You can cry. It's not emotion. It's not feeling different. I'm tired of people coming here and feeling different and living the same way. Metanoia. Meta is change. Noia, mind. Repent. I'm going to think different. I'm not going to... That hadn't worked. Glory to God. Hallelujah. For faith releases the thoughts of God to us and results in a whole and healthy mind. Now here's your verse for the new year, Isaiah 26, verses 3 and 4. Are you ready for this? You will keep him in perfect peace who has an emotional jerk at the church. You will keep him in perfect peace who speaks in tongues all the time. You'll keep him in perfect peace who believes in eternal security. You'll keep him... See, it's not about your doctrine. It's not about your feeling. You will keep him in perfect peace who's what? Mind. Who's got his thinking toward God. Are you getting this? Trust in the Lord forever, for in Yah the Lord is everlasting strength. Matthew 22:37. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your what? You're thinking. Jeremiah 29:11, I know the thoughts I think toward you, said the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil to give you a future and a hope. Now, what are you thinking about your future? Here's what he's thinking. You know what I'm thinking? Here's what God's thinking. I'm going to give them peace. I'm going to give them a future. And I'm going to give them... I know the thoughts, the Lord said, I think towards you. And he's trying to communicate with you that the thoughts you think about you is not what he's thinking about you. See, the devil tell you you're a loser because you lost your job. The devil tell you you're nothing. The devil will come because you've committed sin and say, well, it's hopeless. You're just rotten. Well, he shed his blood to cleanse you and to go on cleansing you. What is God thinking about you? Those old, no good, rotten, low-down, dirty, filthy sinners. I can't wait to smash them into hell. That's not what I just read. I know the thoughts I think towards you. I want you to have a better future. I want you to have peace. I want you to have hope. But you've got to think what he's thinking about you. Look at your neighbor and say, I've got a future.
Well, you are what you think. And you know, the Bible says, as a person thinks, that is what they really are. And Pastor Ron, our thinking, I believe the enemy doesn't want us to understand how important what we think is.
That's right. What we think and confess out of our mouth can transform our lives. The very fact that you have the possibility of taking the Bible and thinking God's thoughts after Him. Let this mind be in you, which was in Christ Jesus. So many of you have your religious emotions in order. You know how to shout, not do this and do that, and you've got all that going, you have all that feeling going, but you're still defeated. It's because they're strongholds of wrong thinking. A stronghold of the enemy is simply a house of wrong thinking. You have believed a lie. You've allowed the enemy to roar in on you. And you know, Jesus said in Luke 12:29, neither be ye of doubtful mind.
Yeah.
You know what the word doubtful is in Greek?
No.
It's meteor. It's really not doubtful. It means your thinking's up in the air.
Yeah.
It's out of orbit. It's sailing around. It's shooting around. You have not captured your thoughts. And I see this as one of the greatest problems in Christianity. But there's hope for you, my dear friend. You can have a renewed mind. And on next week's program, I'm going to take you through the steps to that renewed mind. In the meantime, you need to go ahead right now and order this special two-part teaching. And when you do order it, as a part of your order, we want to include Everyone's Guide to Demons and Spiritual Warfare, which will have the complete steps to mental freedom. And you be sure to be back with us next week.
You are what you think. Learn how to win the war over your mind with Pastor Ron Phillips' best-selling book, Everyone's Guide to Demons and Spiritual Warfare. This comprehensive manual gives you simple, powerful tools for outmaneuvering Satan in your daily life and thoughts. When you order, also ask for a copy of today's message to help you have a winning way of thinking. Call now, 1-800-877-6493, or order online at ronphillips.org. In Everyone's Guide to Demons and Spiritual Warfare, you'll learn the history of your enemy, how to identify the symptoms of demonic activity, how to defeat Satan's strategies, and how to arm yourself for victory. And in today's message, Pastor Ron Phillips gives you seven truths that will give you a winning way of thinking. Call now, 1-800-877-6493, or visit ronphillips.org. You can also send a check or money order for $24.99 to Ron Phillips, P.O. Box 937, Hickson, Tennessee, 37343. Is a place of forgiveness, healing, and hope. That's why Pastor Phillips would like to hear from you and invites you to join us in partnership to take this media ministry to the nations of the world. So call the number on your screen to discover how you can become a partner with Ron Phillips Ministries today. And check out our website at ronphillips.org. So join us again next week. You're always welcome at Abba's House.
Welcome.